Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome back to the today's session. This is Balaji Tanwe teaching you the subject called KOM. And today we are going to cover the next unit, that is the unit number 4, which is going to deal with the new topic, that is CAM and follower. As you remember, in the previous session, we have already studied the basic introduction to the mechanics. We have studied the different kinds of motions and we have seen some of the mechanisms which are categorized under the different categories. Now, as you people are aware that the mechanisms are classified in different categories, and one of the important categories is what? Based on the types of pairs. So when the two links are combined together and based on the contact between them, whether it is a complete surface contact or whether it is a line contact or a point contact, based on that it is classified into two types. The first one is a lower pair and the second one is a higher pair. Now we have seen in the first three units the different types of mechanisms which comes under the category of lower pair. Now I just want to make very clear here the difference between the lower pair and higher pair is exactly what. So when the two links are connected together, they do have a surface in contact, and if the contact is available between them is in a such a way that the surface to surface or area contact takes place and a relative motion exists between the two links, then that type of links are known as the lower pair. Example of that one is all our basic mechanisms which we have dealt in the very first two, three units. Coming back to higher pair, when the two links are joined or combined or connected together and the contact between them is forming in the form of either a point contact or a line contact, then the pairs are known as higher pair. Now this particular unit number 4 is dealing about the higher pair mechanisms. So there are plenty of mechanisms which do comes under this category. So the very important from the subject point of view are two. One is a CAM and follower. Another one more important types or example of the higher pair is a gear and gear types. So today we are going to deal the first type of higher pair mechanism, that is CAM and follower. Moving back to the syllabus, so here we have a different topics which are going to be covered under this particular unit. So first we need to understand what is types of CAMs, types of follower. Then we need to analyze the motion of the CAM and follower depending upon the displacement of the follower. So it is further divided into three types based on the displacement of the follower, velocity of the follower, acceleration of the follower. And there are some numericals which we are going to deal based on the motions of this follower. Moving back to, we are again, once we understood the various motions, then we need to find some numericals on our following types of CAMs which are described over here. So the disc type of CAM with reciprocating follower, having a knife edge, roller and flat face follower. So these are the all types of follower. Now, as we have a different types of CAMs, like that we have a different types of follower. So we'll have a combination of different CAMs with different follower. So we'll see one by one. Next slide, please. Now, so to understand what is exactly a higher pair and what is the role of CAM and follower, now this picture gives you an importance of the CAM and follower. Now looking at this particular diagram, now if you see, this is the diagram which represents the construction of IC engine combustion chamber. If you see here, this is the hatching area. Hatching part is what actually the cut part of your engine cylinder. And if you see here we have the very important component or mechanism which we are going to study in this particular unit, which is a CAM and the follower. Now this element or this mechanism or a component plays a crucial role in operating the opening and closing of the valves in a IC engine. It may be a two-wheeler, it may be a four-wheeler. So the functioning or working of two-wheeler and four-wheeler engine takes place by the opening and closing of these valves. It may be an inlet valve or it may be an exhaust valve. Now if you look into this particular diagram, here the opening and closing of this particular valve will be actuated by means of a device called as a cam and follower arrangement. Now if you see here, the component which is existing here in the blue color form is a cam, and the link, one more link which is in contact with the cam, which is shown here with the green color, is a follower, and these two members together will be held in contact with these arrangement. Now if you see, when this cam revolves, now if you look into construction of the cam, then you will find that the shape of the cam will not be a uniform or a regular shape. It will be irregular shape. It may be any kind of shape depending upon the output desired at this particular output level or at the end level. So based on the output required here, the shape of the cam is going to vary or going to change. In the same way, due to some technical issues, there may be a slightly changes also made in the shape of the follower. So most popularly used followers are knife edge follower, flat faced follower are the popularly used. Now here if you see here, the flat faced follower, and here we have a oval shape of cam. Cam may be a circular, cam may be a square in shape, cam may be a triangular in shape, cam may be in any irregular shape, that we will see in detail when we go further to the next slide. Now if you look at here, so this is the follower, this is the cam, and if you see this motion imparting or the transmission of motion from these two links will be taken place or will be transformed to this particular device, which is we call it as the valve. Now this valve will be going to operate by means of this cam and follower with the arrangement shown here. So to impart the motion from the cam and follower to this particular operating valve is done by the other accessories like push rod, then rocker arm, then we'll have a rocker shaft here, and we'll have here the joint where this particular rocker arm is going to be connected, and through this rocker arm the motion will be given to this particular valve, and when valve is suppressed down, then it has to come back, it has to retain its original position back, and this is what done by means of a element called as the spring. So here the valve is pressed against the spring force due to the force exerted by this cam and follower through this rocker arm on this particular stem of the valve. So once the valve has got compressed or it has moved down with the compression of the spring, when the force is released from this cam and follower, then again the valve will retain back to its original position by the effect of a spring. Now this is what the overall arrangement which we popularly find in the automobile. It may be in the case of two-wheeler or it may be in the case of four-wheeler. So what exactly happening here? Now we have understood, we have come to know that valve, cam and follower are used here to operate the valve. But how exactly this is happening? Now basically if you go to the working principle of a cam and follower, so the cam and follower are the mechanism which are a higher pair mechanism which are responsible for transforming the one form of motion into another form. Now coming back to the working principle, if you see, imagine or visualize the things here. Now imagine that this cam is connected to a shaft which is called as a cam shaft, and that cam shaft is further connected to the engine shaft. Now imagine when engine rotates, the engine shaft rotates, and the cam shaft which is connected or which is mounted on the engine shaft, or the cam is mounted on the engine shaft, so this cam also rotates. So the motion of the cap will be along the axis of the shaft, and it will be always in the rotary form. So this rotary form is will be imparting, or it will be transmitting the motion to this member. Now you can imagine when the cam rotates, due to this irregular profile, which is you can see here in the form of oval, or is called as egg shape, right? So when this cam rotates, initially imagine that if there is no irregularities present over here and this cam is rotating on its own axis, then do you find any displacement in this particular follower? Definitely not. Now this irregular shape which is given to this cam is a crucial and important role. It plays an important role. Because of this irregular shape only, the displacement will be given through the cam to the follower. Exactly, you can visualize that if this embossed portion is not existing, then under that case there won't be a contact between the cam and follower at a regular interval. So when this cam revolves, due to this irregular shape, what happened? The follower will be lifted up whenever this irregular shape comes. Now you can imagine this is a cam. I'll explain with respect to this. Now imagine that this is a cam, and initially if it is completely circular, then there won't be any further movement in the follower. But when irregular shape comes like this, so what is happening? My follower is little bit moving up, right? So when this profile touches the stem of the flat face of the follower, then this follower will try to move up. So there is a displacement. So what is happening here? The rotary motion of the cam is converting into the reciprocating motion of the follower. So here the motion is transformed as well as modified. As we studied in the introduction class, basically the mechanism is made for modifying as well as transforming the motions from one link to another link. Now this is the one link, this is the another link. So these two links are in contact. So link one is producing the rotary motion. Then this rotary motion is imparted to the link number two, that is here in this case it is the follower. So rotary motion is converted into the reciprocating motion. Now when this follower lifts up, what is going to happen? There is a upward force created on this particular link, which is we call it as a rocker shaft as well as the rocker arm. So as a result, what happens? This rocker arm will be going to get the oscillating motion about this particular point. So when this part or this portion of the rocker arm is going to lift it up, obviously the other half portion will be pressed against this particular point. So when it is pressing down, then definitely this is applying a force, or it is pressing the wall in the downward direction. So as a result, what happened? The port or the wall, which are closed because of the initial position of the wall, will get opened, and at that time the fresh air fuel mixture gets entered into the combustion chamber, if this is the case of inlet coil. Same process if I take exhaust valve into consideration, during that period also the same phenomenon takes place. The exhaust valve gets open and closed. When it gets open, when follower moves up, then this valve gets down, then it creates a passage to get open, and from this fresh air fuel mixture enters if it is a inlet valve. If it is a exhaust valve, then due to the downward movement of the valve, the already burnt gases, carbon dioxide, monoxide, all burnt gases, they will escape out from the passage, which is get opened because of the downward movement of the valve. So like this, the function takes place. So this is what an important application of cam and follower, where we learned that cam and follower is the higher pay, and it is responsible for transforming the motion from rotary to reciprocating, or vice versa is also possible. And important application of this one is to open and close the valve in case of IC engine. Hope you understood. So if any queries, then you can ask. Otherwise, with this, I just want to conclude our today's session here. In the next class, we'll see the various types of cams and follower and its application. Thank you. Thank you.